Bardock, why are you going through so much trouble? It's not like a Saiyan man to worry about his children. So what's gotten into you?
What would Bardock think of Goku today? Would he despise his soft heart and kindness? Or would he be proud of his strength and courage? Under normal circumstances, Saiyans are not allowed to keep their bodies in the afterlife. But in this story, because of his heroic sacrifice against Frieza, Bardock is allowed a short time back into the living world to see the results of his sacrifice. He decides to use that time to visit Goku. And this is what happens. Bardock is teleported right in front of Goku, and they both lock eyes. Bardock had no idea what to expect, or even how many years had passed since he's died. "Kakarot?" he mumbled. "Yeah, you know me?" responded Goku. "It seems like I've seen you somewhere before. In fact, you look just like me," said Goku, as Bardock takes a step forward. He then grabs Goku and places his head in his chest, in a way a father would his little boy. "You're pretty damn grown up," he says. Surprised and embarrassed, Goku thinks this is kind of common. At the same time, Gohan and Goten come looking for Goku. "Father, the food is delicious over here," said Gohan. And then he noticed the slightly awkward scene between his dad and Bardock. "Gohan?" said Bardock. "Kakarot, is this your son?" "Yeah, he is," responded Goku. And then Bardock begins to walk over towards Gohan. I love the expression here on Gohan's face because it says that he recognizes Bardock's importance. It's the way you look at someone when you're trying to figure out if you're in trouble or not. As far as strength goes, Gohan is probably thousands of times stronger than Bardock is, but none of that matters when you're staring at a parent. And even though Gohan doesn't know that Bardock is his grandfather, the look on his face says that he can sense some sort of connection. "Big brother, that mister is coming over here," said Goten to Gohan. Bardock stops in front of Gohan, and for the first time, he stretches out his hand and touches his grandson. He pats him on the head. Similar to Goku, Gohan doesn't resist. Bardock asks, "Is the old man treating you well?" Yes, said Gohan, blushing slightly. "I see," responds Bardock. Then he looks at Goten. Goten looks up inquisitively. Bardock says, "You look just like Kakarot," as he lifts Goten off the ground. Goten responds, "I don't look like a carrot. I'm Goten." "Goten, huh? Isn't that a nice name?" At the same time, Bardock hears someone yell "Goku" behind them. "Who's that?" he asks. He turns around and sees Goku standing next to Chi-Chi. "Is that your wife?" he says. Goku nods. "Ah," said Bardock, as his presence began to fade. "Is it time for me already?" "Kakarot," he said, "your beautiful wife, your family, take good care of them." "Ah," said Goku, as Bardock disappeared. A tear rolled down Goku's face as Chi-Chi tells him, "I kind of feel like that was your father, Goku." And that's where this short story ends. If you made it this far in the video, hashtag Bardock forever in the comments below. I did my best to try and find the author of this story, but I couldn't. So if anyone knows the author, feel free to leave it in the comments below or send me a message, and I'll be sure to give credit in the description of this video. Thank you guys for all the support. Hashtag Dude Crew. Happy 2020. I will be talking to you again real soon. Bye.